It's a private matter between me and her. It's not your business. It's not anyone's business. So don't stick your nose in where it doesn't belong.
You just remember who you're talking to.
Oh, I do. Let's face it, Jim. If Sheila wants a relationship with me, there's nothing you can do about it. So why don't you do us both a favor and back off?
Do you have to do that in here?
It's only a quick top coat. What's wrong with you?
Honey.
Go ahead, Sarge.
I need someone to pick up a cake.
Yeah, I'll do it. Anything. Have you paid for it?
Yeah, well, don't worry. I'll pay you back. Now, the bakery's next to the Home County's Building Society. All right, in the name of Hunter.
How's it going?
Yeah, well, Gov. The equipment's still set up, but there's been no movement so far.
Well, they've had a good run, haven't they? I doubt they're going to risk leaving it there much longer.
It's going to be very hard to prosecute Mr. Greaves' daughter without his cooperation.
There's got to be something we can do. We can't just let his daughter march in there, beat up her elderly father and get away with it.
The neighbour who reported the incident only heard the sounds of an argument.
No, a violent argument is what she said. And she saw the daughter leaving.
Yes, but she didn't witness an assault. So right now, the only people that actually know what went on was Mr. Greaves and his daughter.
Well, if the daughter didn't do it, then why is he lying? We know it wasn't those kids that he's made up. Come on, Sarge. Look, we can't just drop this. At least let us go and talk to his daughter.
What do you think, Terry? Terry, what do you think?
Yeah, I think it's worth a shot.
Okay, well, you go ahead then. But if she denies it, and if Mr. Greaves doesn't want to prosecute and we don't have any other witnesses, there's not a lot we can do apart from record the details of the investigation, and at least we've got that if something else turns up. Okay?
I'm not going to give this up.
Terry.
Oh, yeah. Well,
interesting. Since when does a beggar use a cash card? That's our man. Come on.
Suspect's lifting the gear. Get to the ATM.
Go, go, go.
No.
Oi!
You okay?
No. I've broken a nail.
Nice of you to join us, PC Harman. Where have you been? Buying a cake.
Yeah?
Miss Greaves? I'm Detective Constable Nadir. This is Detective Constable Perkins. I'd like a word with you about your father.
Go out your room, Ryan.
What's going on?
Go out your room now.
No. I want to know what's going on.
Your son?
Yeah.
We want to talk to your mum about something, all right? I'm not going.
Fine by us. It's all right with you, Miss Greaves.
Yeah, might as well know.
Good.
Know what?
All right, before you start, yes, I did go round to my dad's. Yes, we had a fight. But it's between the two of us, all right?
No, it's not just between the two of you, Miss Greaves. We have a duty to investigate an alleged criminal offence.
Has he pressed charges? Has he?
Are you saying you assaulted your dad?
I'm saying we had a fight. Look what he's done to me. It's not all one-way traffic.
Tell me what happened.
You wouldn't understand.
I'm very broad-minded.
Oh, don't be clever. I told you what happened. I went round, we had an argument, got into a fight.
What was the argument about?
Private matter. Ask him. Has he told you?
I'm asking you.
I don't have to answer.
Your father has alleged that some items of jewellery were stolen.
Well, not by me, they weren't.
And you won't mind if we search this flat, will you?
You can't search unless you arrest me.
She's right.
She is.
Miss Greaves, I'm arresting you on suspicion of assault and theft. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Why don't you talk to me about it, eh? I'm not some ogre.
No, go. I just couldn't see you giving me any time off in the middle of a job.
Yeah, well, there's always a way around these things, Phil. Sending Honey away nearly screwed up the entire operation.
Yeah, I know, Gov, and I'm sorry. All right, it was my fault. I promised I'd sort out the cake. I've even forgot her party.
Well, when is it?
4:30. Christine's making some big deal about it, like it's life and death. She's invited every relative, every friend she knows. Said Maddie's never had a birthday party before.
Well, you got some more bad news. I spelled the name wrong. That's all right, just take the N out. She's 4, she can't spell unless she's a genius, which I doubt with you as her father. Now, just stick some candles over it. Look, be all right.
What do you mean, stick some candles over it?
Well, you're late, aren't you? But if you go now, you've still got time to pin the tail on the donkey. Go on.
Nice one, Gav.
You won't find anything, because I didn't take it. The jewellery's probably still in his flat, unless he's pawned it. He's made it all up so he can claim on the insurance.
Zane, I've got something in here. After this, under the bed, you recognise these?
Save the rainforest babies. Didn't we get a load of complaints about this lot?
As in, there's no such charity. Well, looks like someone's been busy collecting for these poor babies. You know anything about this?
They're mine.
Well, then we're just going to have to nick you for deception as well, aren't we?
No, it's not her. She don't know nothing about it.
Keep out of this, Ryan.
You're not getting into trouble. It was me. I did the printing and the collection.
Shut up, Ryan. How stupid are you? Don't listen to him.
You're not going to prison, all right? I don't want you to go to prison.
He's just lying to protect me. You can't arrest him. I've already said I've done it. It's got nothing to do with him.
Ryan?
Don't even think about saying anything after everything I've done for you!
It wasn't her. It was me.
But one of you's lying. Do you want to toss a coin for it?
All right. This is the truth. I got involved with a charity scam. My dad found out, said he's going to grass me up. That's when we had our little discussion.
You assaulted him?
Yeah, but I didn't rob him. He's either lost that stuff or he's fiddling the insurance, all right. Are you going to charge me with assault or whatever and get on with this?
Why would your dad suddenly grass you up? He could have done that straight away, but instead he spent most of today making up stories about being robbed or assaulted by somebody else.
Yeah, well, maybe he's frightened of me. I beat him up, didn't I?
Or maybe somebody's not telling us the truth.
Look, you just said. Your dad was going to grass you up. You can't have it both ways. He's either afraid of you or he isn't.
Look, I'm holding my hands up to assault here. Can you get on and charge me? What are you arguing about?
Well, I'm not arguing with you, Miss Greaves. I just don't believe you're telling us the whole story.
It's the only story you're getting out of me.
Do you think Ryan will tell us a different story?
All right. Tell you the truth. I mean it this time.
Good. We're listening.
I've done my best to bring Ryan up properly. I never had anything. His dad left when he was a baby. But I've done my best to give him what I never had. He was doing all right at school. Then my dad started to get to him.
Doing what exactly?
Stopped offering him little jobs, bits of easy money. None of it legal. Tells him that work's just for failures. And I realise I'm losing him. My own son. Sometime soon, a year, 2 years, he's going to end up where my dad spent most of his life, behind bars.
Your dad's got a record.
Check it out. He only got out from his last stretch a year ago. Fraud. He was the one that put Ryan up for that bogus charity.
Well, then why was all the stuff around at your flat and not at his?
Doesn't that tell you how much he cares about his own grandson? When I found out, I just lost it.
And why didn't you come and see us?